Hello everybody, my name is Michael Woodside and I'm an animator, and today I'm going to teach you how to draw Bruni from Frozen 2. So first things first, we're going to clean our hands off. I have this sanitizer here, and our art supplies, at least in my case, are in the supply drawer and they're just sort of collecting dust and probably germs. So I'm just going to clean off my hands before we get started. And then also I'll show you the tools that we'll be using. I have this light blue pencil that I'll be working with for most of the drawing, and then I'm going to go over later with this black line. I have a couple pencils here to color it in, so it's blues and purples and reds. If you don't have those colors, you can always just color it in with a blue or one color like we normally do, but figured he's a pretty simple character, so I wanted to get a chance to draw and color him in for you. So, you know, normally we start with circles. I'm going to do that over here on this side, just sort of sketchy circles to warm up your arm, warm up your brain, warm up your heart. These are good too because it takes the pressure off of doing a perfect drawing. I think a lot of times you might think you need to do it perfectly the first time, and you probably won't because we're learning how to do it together. So hopefully at the end of this video you'll have a better idea as to how to tackle Bruni. Don't tackle him, he's pretty temperamental, but you know what I mean. And the nice thing about drawing this way is that we can come over later with a darker pencil and then decide which lines we want to continue to look at and then get rid of the ones that we don't want to see anymore. So if we just outline these certain parts of the circle, then all the other ones sort of fade away, especially once we start shading it in. And then for Bruni, since he's this blue color, a lot of what we shade in is actually going to be the same color. So, fades in even more. All right, let's get started. I'm gonna draw his head over here and then leave enough room for his body. His body is actually pretty simple, so we're gonna try to see if we can do all of it. Maybe a simplified version of the legs. So let's draw the head right here. It's just a circle. You can see I'm starting light and just sort of going over and over. I say we're drawing one circle, but you can see I've drawn 15 circles so far, trying to make one out of it. They're really scratchy, but again, once we darken in the lines, then we won't see how scratchy it was. Okay, so that is our circle for Bruni's head. Now, which way should he look? I have this little ping pong ball to show us which way we can have him turn. So the vertical line is the center of the head that direction, and the horizontal line is the center of the other direction. So normally we draw characters, if we're drawing like Mickey, we draw them straight on, or if we have other characters that have more directionality, we can turn them and then sort of decide. So Bruni is going to be looking straight at us, however his head's going to be turned to the side like this. So our horizontal line is actually going to be diagonal this way, and our vertical line is diagonal this way. I'll show you what I mean. Let's do the vertical line. Let me go over here. And then the horizontal line, we're gonna have a little bit lower than center, right about here. Make it a more centered vertical line. Color that in and no one will ever know. Okay, so let's go ahead and put his little nose in there. That's an easy one. So the nose is just a little bump that happens above the middle line. That. And he has these tiny, tiny little nostrils that are just little diagonal lines that go here. Just on either side to kind of point up that direction. Okay, so he has these huge, huge eyes. So we're going to start them outside of the circle. I know that sounds weird, but they kind of stick up over here. I'm kind of building the circle as I go. Getting bigger than that. See how big that eye is? It's huge. It's a salamander, so they have enormous eyes. Okay, so let's go ahead and build out the side of his head, because we know that his head doesn't end here. It's kind of a football shape. So starting from the outs at the top of the head, I'm just going to start building the football shape that goes through the eyes. Of course, we won't darken that line in. And then connects down here to the bottom. Let's draw it really light. Same on the other side. Should be the same size from one side to the other. So it's important to draw, you see animation drawings, they're always, all these lines are through other things. It's not, it's just a clean outline. That's because animators are thinking about things dimensionally. So their job is to turn things around in space and have characters walk and smile and run and fall. And all of that has to happen in this kind of like imagined dimensionality. So that's why we're drawing through, is because we know that eventually Bruni will have to turn his head and that line will show itself later. So let's go ahead and start these eyebrows. The eyebrows are pretty easy. They're just big upside down letter U's, or like a soft letter N right there. And of course we don't see the whole eye like this. It's pretty similar, if you remember when we drew Pascal, we kind of cut off the inside of the eye. I don't cut it off, that's just where his lower eyelid is. So it's just a rounded line that connects from above the eye through the inside of the circle that we first drew, just a little bit, and then outside here. We just connect those. It's easy with a rounded line right there. All right, now we're going to draw the mouth. He's going to have a big happy smile, but to get his smile, we actually have to start with a frown. So we're going to draw a frown that's a big wide frown. See how it sticks outside of the circle? Sad Bruni. And we take that frown and then we turn it into a smile by scooping up the outsides into his little cheekies. So he's got a great expressive mouth, so I'm just gonna draw it open, like a big smile. And we already have where the bottom of the mouth is. It's gonna be at the bottom of the football, so I'm gonna start there. But it's gonna go wider, but not all the way out to the side. It's actually gonna end right about here. Follow around the bottom of the circle. Back up here. Change on this eye, and it's going to be easy to fix once we put in the iris. I felt like this eyelid was a little too short, so we're not making perfect drawings, we're practicing. All right, now let's draw the iris. So that is going to be a circle inside his eyeball, but he's looking right at us, so just going to have it right there. Same on the other side. And then he's got a little pupil inside there. So it's a smaller circle. And we're gonna give a little highlight. A lot of circles. Not really any straight lines on Bruni. No corners. So, to show you that, normally when we draw tongues, we draw them like those, we call them M-birds. Like if you're drawing a bunch of birds flying away, look like that. So the tongue usually looks like that, like in Mickey or any other character goofy. But for Bruni, it's like this middle part gets really soft because he's a salamander. They have really wide tongues. So it's kind of like an M, but a little softer in the middle. And the middle is right in our vertical line that we did here. All right, so before we're done with the head, we want to give him a little bit of the smile lines. And similar when we talked about the Mickey smile, it's a little nose. Automatically, I drew these little cheeky lines that go on both sides of the top lip smile. But for Bruni, it's just on the outside. And that gives him this cute overbite. Okay, I promised you were drawing the body, so let's go ahead and get started with that. So starting from this outside cheek on the left, we're just gonna draw a straight line, a little bit of curve in it that goes down here. Stops about there. That's his little neck. And we'll just continue this around a little bit. His head is turned. And then do another line that goes out this way. So if you leave it like that, it could be a dinosaur. It's not necessarily Bruni yet. So you gotta give him his little salamander body. So similar to how we drew the football that's tilted this way, we're gonna draw like an egg that's turned this way. So egg is fatter over on one end, and then it comes slightly to a point, so the point is going to be in his chest, and we're going to draw the fatter end down here. And when I want to draw really soft, I turn my pencil sideways so that I can use the side of the pencil rather than the point, and you can get a much softer line that way. Connect that neck into it here. Let's make this real. Okay, so I want to start with his back leg. So the back leg happens right here. So if we're looking at the egg shape, it's right at the big fat part of the egg down here at the bottom. And then it's a tube that sticks out this way. So we're just going to draw a straight line tube that goes out here. Pretty far. And then rounds down. But his legs, if we were to see him just standing up straight, his legs wouldn't be like this kind of tube. It's the kind of tube that gets really pudgy down at the bottom. Pudgy bottom tube. So we're gonna give him one of those here. I just drew softly a rounded line here, and then it kind of gets a little bit thinner when it gets up to the top. So we'll go in and make those feet a little bit more detailed soon. But we have four of them to draw, so we want to make sure that we get through all of them. Okay, so the next leg we're going to draw is maybe the hardest. So let's take our time with it. Let's say his shoulder is right here. I'm just going to draw a circle right here, just lightly, so that we know where the width of it is. And we're going to put the first line that comes down here. Think of an S curve. So let's practice that real quick. So we talked about before that we use C shapes, S shapes, or straight lines all the time when we draw. So an S shape is the letter S, but think about the tops and bottoms being stretched out. Something like that. And so for him, it's like a backwards letter S stretched out. So it's like, that's the shape we're looking for. So it starts there I think it's really pudgy at the bottom, like COVID has made all of us. He's got the front rounded line here for the front of his feet. And then starting here again, he's gonna draw kind of a straight line for the upper arm from the outside of that little circle that we drew for the shoulder. And then another rounded line out here. Look at that cute little foot. Hello, Bruni. Bruni was supervised for Frozen 2 by my friend Trent Corey. A lot of great animation from the team on this character. Super cute. And it was fun because it was the kind of thing where one person would animate one thing and then the directors would fall in love with it and that would become a characteristic, like the tongue licking the eye or the jump. Dave Harden, I believe, animated the tongue licking the eye first, and the jump was animated by Jeff Williams. A lot of really cool, cute animation that characteristic is just became ideas from the animators and the story artists. It's fun to see these characters come to life. All right, let's do the front leg that is behind his body. So if we drew the circle here, we just know that we're gonna have a little bump for the front of the leg. And then let's just say it's straight. And a rounded line here. Eventually we'll give little toesies. And the back foot is actually gonna be right about here. So we can just draw that by kind of drawing a number 7. Get back there. Okay, before we get to the toesies, let's draw the tail. So the tail starts at the bottom here and just comes up like a letter S. See that S? Backwards S? And again, it doesn't come to a point. It's a little rounded edge there. Connects in with another S. A lot of curves. And actually, I'm gonna make another big adjustment. It'll be fine. I'm gonna give him a thinner neck at the top here. Yeah. So, drawing for me is you do it, and then you react to it, and then you can make adjustments to it. And once we color everything in and make it final, then, you know, I'll remember that, oh, normally I draw his neck too thick. I should look out for that. But he also has a little, since his head is turned this way, we should draw a little bump here, like he's got some little chunk collecting there. All right, and then we can now solidify this line a little bit by curving it in and then going around the chest bone. All right, I promise some toesies. So we're just gonna softly draw these little beans down here. This is like his little thumb beans that come towards the center, and then do a rounded line here and just do some other beans this way. Now, there's a color separation, so I'm just going to start drawing, continuing this neckline down into underneath the armpit. and you can just draw it and kind of go in here. So this top part is a little darker blue than the belly. Finish off these toes. A little more squared off at the edge. All right, let's go ahead and outline them now. All right, I am right-handed, so I like to work from left to right. So that means for this drawing, the last thing we're going to work on is the face. So I'm just going to start, go ahead and outline the feet first. The reason I do that is because my hand, yep, perfect, is likely to smudge the drawing and kind of make it look super, a lot more messy than I want it to. So if I work on the left to the right, then I'm not actually smudging it. Let's just go ahead and get all these little shapes built in. Sharpen. Break it. Every time I sharpen it, it breaks. So just good to get that over with early. So I was also a supervisor on Frozen 2. It's just so much fun. I worked on the first Frozen as a crowds animator. So I was animating background characters who were kind of reacting to Elsa's magic when she first does it in the castle. She runs out of the courtyard. Got to animate a few shots. I actually animated Elsa after she leaves Arendelle. She runs over across the shore, and then like when she reaches the shore and she's like that big on screen, I animated that. But it was mostly animating crowd cycles and background characters, and that's how most people start at Disney. So for Frozen 2, I was one of the animation supervisors who supervised Sven and the parents. Duna and Agnar, as well as a writer. But my main focus on the show was the crowds team. So it's a team of new animators who came in. Most were fresh, new to the industry in animation, and helped them do their cycles and get to know the way that Disney makes films. And then eventually they did some very cool full shots in the film after they did a lot of really great cycles. A cycle is an animation that starts and ends the same, so that the crowds team, the crowds effects artists, will take the cycles and sort of duplicate them over and over and over again and fill the town with all these people who are walking together and talking and laughing or running away from Salamander. So it's cool to be a crowds animator on the first Frozen and then help bring crowds animators into the studio for the second one. See how once you do these black lines, you sort of forget about all the little mistakes I hope people finish these drawings. I know that it can be a little frustrating if it doesn't look exactly the way you think it does, or here all the time as people are learning to draw, they're like, mine doesn't look at all like yours. But it will. Just have to give it a second. Drawing takes a long time. This is probably your first time drawing Bruni, and it is probably my 50th at least. Someone like Trent, who supervised Bruni, has probably drawn him 1,000 times at least. So the more familiar an artist is with a character, the more accurately they can draw them. And you can do that too if you just practice. Break. There it is. So even though I work for Disney, these drawing classes are just for me, just for fun. So I'm not getting paid for this. This is just, I wanted to teach you all how to draw these characters, and I hope that you enjoy learning how to do it. I love seeing your drawings too. So this is a fun thing I started about a year ago. So it's been great getting to meet you all over the past year and then see all of your drawings. Alright, I promised you we're going to color them in, so let's do it. I'm going to start with the eyeballs. I'm just going to go dark here. Oh, this is cool. This song is when we meet Bruni. Frozen 2 score by Christoph Beck, and one of the coolest days, the Frozen supervisors were actually allowed to go to the recording studio when the orchestra was recording. It's one of the last things that happens on our films, and I love music. I was in band when I was in school. I played the bassoon. Do not play the bassoon anymore, but play the piano and trying to learn how to play the guitar. Just very interested in music. So to hear this come to life, and these musicians, most people don't know, are learning how to play the song as they're recording it. That's how good they are. So this is their first time playing this song. This music. Which is wild. Course. But this is being recorded right before lunch, so if you listen closely, you can probably hear my stomach grumble. All right, I'm gonna color in the top part, kind of a darker blue than this light blue. And even if we're not allowed or able to make it into there because the stages are huge, but they don't allow a ton of people in at a time. If you're working at the Disney Animation Studio, they actually will live stream video, so you can watch the orchestra play from your desk, which is, it's always so inspiring because we're listening to temp score for most of the making of the film, and then at a certain point, everything comes together with the sound editors and composers and all the musicians, sound effects, Foley. Makes such a big difference in the film, and it's one of the last things to come in. So for most people, when they hear or they see the film in the wrap party, that's the first real experience they've had with the movie because all of the sound effects are in there and everything is rendered finally. shading in these little sections. Okay, so like I said, this front part of his body is going to be light blue, but his legs and his back and tail are all darker blue. So if you're using the same blue, you can just push darker, push harder on your pencil when you draw the darker sections. And then when you get to the lighter sections, you could just not push as hard. And it kind of gives a similar effect. Drawing little cute characters like Bruni. These soft lines that we did, these S shapes and C shapes, those are really valuable to use to help show that he's sort of a non-threatening character. Even though if you scare him, he turns into fire. For the most part, he's an adorable little guy. Other leg. Start pre-shading in some things, which is just as it gets closer to the body, just get it a little bit darker. Darker here, darker in the armpits, bottom of the toesies. Tail. I'm gonna color in the tail. Before we do that, I'm gonna draw these little, he has these little spots, purpley spots. So I'm gonna put that here. And then we can go in with the dark blue. Sections. Now I have this dark blue. The inside of the mouth is going to be a different color, but I'm going to, rather than using the black to do it, I'm just going to start laying in some dark blue, and then we'll come in with a different color and mix on top of that. Parts. So you can even see the underdrawing now. The scratchy lines we had in there, they're gone. That drawing takes time. So the character designer on Frozen 2 and Frozen was Bill Schwab. Designs a lot of the films of Disney. Really appealing shapes to animate. And he also helps out once the animators start and does drawings over their animation videos to to suggest how the character could be even more on model. Yeah, on model means consistent with the design philosophy of the character. So Mickey shouldn't have square ears. So if Mickey ever had square ears, then someone like Bill Schwab, character design would come in and be like, hey, maybe they should be round like Mickey's ears. And so yeah, he's a really valuable member of the team. And a very nice guy. So we have this blue. We drew this in really lightly, but for the color of his eyes, I want to color that in really solid. Because he has these like brilliant glowing blue eyes. Before we move on to the mouth, he's got the purple spots in his head too, so I'm just gonna give him a few of those. Wherever you wanna put him. Okay, so his tongue, bright pink tongue, so I'm gonna just use my red really lightly. Okay. And now I'm just going to mix in some of that red with the inside of the mouth. Kind of make a purpley kind of warm color in there. Gotta give him something to stand on, so I'm just gonna use the side of my pencil right under each of the feet and just kind of scratchy lines that are always going side to side. Against that. The ground. And one last little thing with the red. Him a little. Little flame up there. So it's a rounded line, a C curve, and then a long C curve that goes this way. And then we'll just color that in the outsides of it. And there we go. We got Bruni. Don't forget to sign your drawing. I'm going to sign mine right down here. I hope you had fun drawing Bruni with me. We are, of course, on Instagram and Twitter. That's where I want to see your drawings, please. So use the hashtag drawingwithwoodsy. You can also tag me in it. My name is AnimWoodsy online. And that way I can see your drawing and share your drawing. I hope you enjoyed drawing Bruni. He's one of my favorite cute little guys, and we haven't drawn him yet, so I'm glad that we've finally got a chance to do that. Just doing some last minute shading. Because I'm a perfectionist, and I don't know when to quit. Okay, probably now, almost, just about, right up, almost. You guys, he's a cute little guy. Okay. Anyway, I hope you had fun. Share your drawing, share it with a friend, give it to someone special. And remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. So I thank you for spending your time with me. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye now.